Welcome back to Obermatt Stock Investing. This week something happened that you couldn't have overseen. England left the European Union and everybody panics. You know, the stock markets crash and, you know, we all think this is going to be the end of the world. It probably isn't. As a matter of fact, the banks are already taking advantage of that fact and have received advertising from BlackRock, the largest asset manager worldwide. And BlackRock told me, hey dude, you know, relax, we have everything under control, we knew about this for a long time, I have the right products for you. And I looked at the flyer that they sent me, which you have here in front of you, and I realized they're actually advertising cash equivalents, short-term bonds to buy for 1% yield. And they're also recommending a low volatility stock index. Now, should you buy that? Of course not, because everybody does that right now. And what does that mean for prices? It means prices raise. Yes, if you do now what BlackRock is recommending, you do what everybody else does and you pay the highest price. That really doesn't make any sense. I actually wanted to know how bad this is in my own portfolio, and I looked at it, and you see it here in front of you. I have 100,000 to invest this summer, and I've invested about half, and my portfolio is now worth 97,800. I spent about 200 on fees, which means I lost 2% on my investments. Not that bad for such a terrible summer, I think. As a matter of fact, this is not because I'm really smart and I picked the right stocks. It is because I use a very simple principle that you can use too. And it's called slowly in, slowly out. That's what safe investing is all about. Yes, it's that simple. Don't put everything right into the markets. Invest over time, which means in falling stock markets, you still have money to invest. Very, very simple, very, very effective. I only lost 2%, while at the same time, the stock 50, the Euro stock 50, the stock index for the European stocks lost 4%. I'm better off than them, and that's already quite good. Now, what did I do after realizing that? I thought, today I'm doing something different. I went into stock filter, I searched for large stocks, and I searched for UK stocks. I wanted to do exactly the contrary what everybody else does. And you see here the list in front of you. British Telecom is the best combined rating in the UK, followed by Sainsbury. And I thought, I go for Sainsbury. This is even riskier than British Telecom. I buy a retail company, you know, Main Street, basically, that is probably going to suffer the most from Brexit. I'm going to buy that. Now, is this stupid? It isn't, because everybody thinks Sainsbury is a bad investment. So the prices have already come down. You know, I'm actually at equal foot with everybody right now, even if the future of Sainsbury is bad. And I bought this stock because I wanted to know 1, 3, or 5 years down the road, how good was that stock investment actually. Investing in the stock that nobody recommends right now, in a country that nobody recommends, and I'm actually quite confident. You can see it here in my portfolio, which I show you. Here is the order for Sainsbury, and next week it will be in my portfolio for sure. Thank you very much for being with us, and I hope you enjoy your own stock investing. Bye-bye.